What's up, everybody? It is Shenanigan here with another video, and I am really excited to talk about something that actually, funny enough, I was speculating yesterday on a Fortnite stream. And yes, around 5 o'clock yesterday, British summer time, I saw that Fortnite and Star Wars is officially collaborating again. Star Wars is coming back to Fortnite, so we're going to break it down all in this video. So it is official that quarter two is kicking off with a bang for Star Wars gaming. So unlike my previous video when I was talking about quarter one, where Star Wars gaming was really hurting, it's like the 1st of April hit and we are kicking off with a bang. So last week we got the Star Wars Outlaws story trailer and its release date of August 30th, but I have a separate video for that. So if you want to click the card above, but yesterday we got news that it is official that Fortnite and Star Wars are having a new May event. But this time it's very interesting that LEGO, Battle Royale, and Festival are all listed. Interesting thing that wasn't mentioned was racing, but I'm going to cover that in a second. So what do we know so far is there's been a bowcaster in the data files that people were able to unlock and see. And speaking to my community yesterday in yesterday morning stream, I think that's one of the last main characters that we haven't received a skin for is Chewbacca. I'm not sure if we're going to get any variations. I mean, Chewbacca didn't really wear a lot of different things. I mean, he did have, like, if we're going back to like the Battlefront skins, you know, we had him with kind of his solo with like some goggles and like a bandage on his arm. So I don't think we're going to get a lot of variations, obviously, of Chewbacca like we do for Luke, Han, Leia, etc. But I think the biggest thing was kind of with discussing with my community skins, someone brought C-3PO up, and I will say I think it would be a bit jarring to have C-3PO as a skin because his arms are like at 45 degree angle and he does this little tiptoe run. Don't think it would look right in as a Fortnite skin, but then it occurred to me he could be a back bling. And who more appropriate to be a back bling for than Chewbacca, because obviously he was on his back in The Empire Strikes Back. So all the, you know, all the speculation and pieces are like falling into place. But of course we could get some other Star Wars characters such as Andor. You know, we also, I mean, another main character who would be more well known now would be Bo-Katan, and everyone loves The Mandalorian. So, and that one, there could be some variations. You could have a helmet on, helmet off. It would be amazing if the Darksaber would be a pickaxe, but I think because again it's very similar to a lightsaber, I would be surprised if we got that, but you know, I want to be surprised. Another person that has not had a skin yet that is from the OG trilogy is Lando Calrissian, and that's another one that could have 2 to 3 variations. You could get the Bespin blue, you could get the guard design disguise, and you could even get kind of his general look. I think it has been confirmed, speaking of General, that General Leia or Rebel Leia is coming to the shop. I've heard 2 different things from various Fortnite content creators. If it's General Leia, that's more sequel trilogy Leia. So she might be in her purple and have more of the gray hair look. If it's Rebel Leia, it could be more from the comic. But what gets me excited with the possibility is if we get like more skins for an already established skin, maybe we'll get more for Rey or Finn. That is Battle Royale. I didn't at first think we were going to get a actual mini pass for it like last year, because I mean, been looking between the times between the various mini passes from like Ninja Turtles to Avatar, I think was a couple of weeks. There was a few others that like, I'm gonna be really shocked if we get another mini pass literally the day Avatar finishes at 2 a.m. I think that's 2 a.m. Pacific time, to then literally the next, like right into Star Wars. Because at first I was like, nah, I think we're just getting an event. But then as I saw one of the people, Felipe, I need to look up his last name, but Felipe, I'll post his tweet here, you know, posted a Darth Vader gif. And he's responsible for creating battle passes and mini passes. So it's pure speculation, but that could be a hint that maybe we are getting a mini pass. But then it actually hit me then at like 2 a.m. yesterday, earlier this morning. Maybe it's even something different, because maybe it's, you remember that kind of cryptic trailer we got back in like February about Disney and Epic and everything? could this be maybe phase one? And like, maybe there's actually like a Star Wars tab, you know, like how we have festival and, you know, rock, you know, racing and all of that, that maybe we get like an actual, this is a section you go to, completely different island, different modes. I don't know. That might be asking a lot, but they did pitch it. We saw on the concept art, we're showing all these different islands, and one was like a Star Wars looking island. So this is where I'm hoping maybe it's going to be literally its own thing, because like I mentioned earlier, there's other parts. There's Lego Fortnite, and there's Festival. Let's go talking about Festival. So I think we're getting some Star Wars instruments, full stop. Like guitar, could be like the shape of the Millennium Falcon, bass, etc. Maybe we could go one step further. Maybe we're gonna get, you know, one of the Cantina band skins, because it's the same looking guy, you just have different instruments. So it could be fun that, you know, what would be a guitar looks like one instrument. I'm sorry, I don't know the in canon names, but that could be exciting. I also do think we may get the Cantina song as a track, because I mean the Ninja Turtles battle pass or mini pass, we got a song. So it would not surprise me if we got the do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. That's pretty much like, I mean, they're pretty much confirming it when Fortnite Festival is saying, I can hear that Cantina theme from here. Like, some people think you were getting, like, the Imperial March or anything. No, guys, like, we're probably getting the Cantina theme. Would be cool if we got the, like, 1970s Mecco version of the Star Wars theme. It's very 70s. If I can find it, you'll be playing it now. But that's really what I think is going on with the festival. But, you know, who knows? We can maybe have a cool background where we're actually playing in a cantina. I mean, I don't know if we'll get deep cuts like Max Rebo and, or, you know, Sly Noodles. If you don't know who that is, that's like a crazy little creature that does the... Yes, that was my impression of that. Let's move into now Fortnite Lego. And this is where I have absolutely no idea what we could be getting. We could get some play sets, because now we know those are in the shop, so we could reflect actual things. I don't know. Like, this is where I don't play that mode. I tried it. It's not my jam, but I might have to. But I'm not quite sure what we would get in Lego. So if you have some ideas, hit me up in the comments, because I really would like to know what you think a possible Star Wars Lego crossover would be. Maybe it's something as simple as we just get the new skins, we'll get Lego variants as well immediately. Speaking of things you could buy in the shop, if you're thinking about snagging yourself any of this Star Wars stuff in the shop, please consider using my creator code Shenanigan, that's with an E-N at the end, and that will help this channel immensely. But now we're going to finally end it on Rocket Racing, which really surprises me that this wasn't in the announcement, because this is the one collab I've already seen. We've already seen that, like, the Mandalorian had vehicles in Rocket Racing. Or in Rocket League, I should say. So you would think, because they're kind of owned now by Epic, and there's like they kind of speak to each other, that like it would be a no-brainer. But I do think it's quite interesting that it's like completely thrown, like not mentioned at all. So who knows? But like I've been secretly kind of sitting back waiting for those cars to come to Rocket Racing. So I don't know. I do think that's quite interesting that that's not there. The thing with like these collabs, it makes me excited is that hopefully we get some more Star Wars prefabs. So that's exciting. But that is kind of it with Rocket Racing. So I don't know what's going on with there, but that's all I have in my first impressions and speculations for the new Fortnite Star Wars event. What do you think? What would you like to see? And again, please consider using my code Shenanigan with an E-N at the end, and I will see you in the next video.